Yeah, since we talked so much about logistic regression now, I thought that might be a good opportunity now to introduce two terms, logits and cross entropy, because that's what I will also use quite often later in this class. And that's because also it's a very common, these are two common terms in the deep learning literature. I sometimes refer to it as the deep learning jargon because, we sometimes use these terms a little bit differently in statistics compared to deep learning. So I just wanted to briefly clarify how they relate to the concepts we just discussed. If this doesn't make complete sense, I mean, we will be using these terms later and you will then have something to refer back to. Okay, so in deep learning, when we have multi-layer neural networks, let's say, I will just draw a very simple one here. We will actually talk about them on Thursday. So if we have a multi-layer perceptron like this, everything is connected to everything here. It's a fully connected layer. And then we have this one output node. And in this network, we also have net inputs similar to adder line or logistic regression. But now we have two net inputs. One is here, let's call that Z1, and one is here, it's Z2. We will talk more about that on Thursday. But yeah, in deep learning, it's very common to call these here, the net inputs that come before the output, to call them the logits. In statistics, the logits have a specific meaning. This is the logarithm of the odds, or log odds. And in the context of logistic regression, which we just covered, these logits are naturally the net inputs. So where does that come from? This is the inverse of our logistic sigmoid function. Oops. That's our logistic sigmoid function. Here just I just abbreviated it as P. So the log of P over 1 minus P. This function is the inverse of this function. And so in deep learning, though, there is not necessarily any relationship between the log odds and the net inputs of the last layer. It's just like, I think it's derived, the term is derived from logistic regression. People call that logits in the context of logistic regression, and then just generalized this wording to arbitrary multilayer perceptrons, where we may not even have a sigmoid function, as we will see later. So you can just think of it as the net inputs of the output of the last layer, basically. So here, just for reference, so here on the left-hand side, the logistic sigmoid function, and here on the right-hand side, the logit. So the logit function is the inverse of the logistic sigmoid function. So basically how it looks like. I don't think I have to go into that in much detail because we have seen that before, and this is essentially just flipped. So there is another concept that is maybe a little bit confusing, but it's exactly what we've covered before. Actually, we had a seminar at UW last week where we also, where it was briefly mentioned coincidentally. There was like a question whether it's the same, the negative log likelihood and the cross entropy. So yeah, the negative log likelihood and the binary cross entropy are equivalent. And in practice, in deep learning, people just say cross entropy, multi-category cross entropy, which would be a multi-class version of the negative log likelihood, which we will cover later in this lecture when we talk about the softmax function. So just to keep it brief, the negative log likelihood that we just covered a few videos ago is the same as what people call the binary cross entropy. They were just formulated in different contexts. So negative log likelihood comes more like from, I think it's like, it's probably from a statistics context. I don't know the first paper or reference that mentioned that, but this is something usually I see in statistics papers. And the binary cross entropy, I think that's originated from the field of information theory or computer science. So we have actually seen that, or not the cross entropy, but we have seen the self entropy or just entropy in statistics 451 for those who took this class. In fall semester, where we had used the entropy function in the context of information theory and decision trees. But we used a log 2 instead of the natural logarithm. But it's kind of somewhat related. If you have taken any class where you talked, for example, about the KL divergence or Kolbeck-Leibler divergence, which measures the difference between two distributions, the KL divergence is essentially the cross entropy minus the self entropy. Of course, you don't have to know that. It's just like a fun tidbit here. The only thing you have to know is, or should know, because it's useful to know, is that the negative log likelihood is the same as the binary cross entropy. This is like a useful thing to know. And this is, yeah, what we've discussed in the previous videos. And there's also a multi-category version. There's the multi-category cross entropy, which is just a generalization of the binary cross entropy to multiple classes. So in order to make that negative log likelihood or binary cross entropy work for multiple classes, we assume a so-called one-hot encoding, where the class labels are either 0 or 1, for some reason it was cut off here. But this is something we of course haven't discussed yet, and if this doesn't make sense yet, we will actually discuss that after the logistic regression code example, when I will introduce the multinomial logistic regression model. So again, all I wanted to say here is the logits in deep learning usually refer to the net inputs of the layer that just comes before the output. And the term binary cross entropy and negative log likelihood are essentially the same. All right, so in the next video, I will show you a logistic regression code example, and then we will take a look at this multi-category cross entropy.